Hello and welcome to another tutorial. This time I'm doing something different and I want to show you how to create a nice vertical zoom effect which I used in my last time-lapse video. This effect will look something like this. And the only thing you need for this is Adobe After Effects. So I made a new composition and now I just drag my footage onto the screen. Please keep in mind I am not a professional After Effects user and I am certain there are tons of other ways to do this effect better, but I think this might help some of you. So the first thing you want to look for is a clear edge with which you can separate the background from the foreground. In this case, I'm going to use the first mountain you can see, and I'm going to mask it out. But first, I want to copy my footage so I have two of the same clip. And now I just can zoom in and start masking out my foreground using the pen tool. You don't have to work accurately here, you can later feather the mask so it will still look good, even if you do make small mistakes here. Now, if I turn off my background layer, you can see I mask out quite good looking foreground. And now everything that's left to do is we need to use some keyframes for the scaling and to create the vertigo effect. So first I want to work with the background layer. And here the first thing I want to do is set the scaling to something around 107%. Then I'm setting a keyframe by pressing on the stopwatch, and then I go to the end of my composition and set the scaling back to 100%. And now I'm doing the same thing for my foreground, but only reverse everything. So I'm going to set a keyframe to my scale options, go to the end of the composition and just scale it up to like 107%. And as you can see, there's a tiny problem here, but this will be easily fixed. First, I want to feather out the mask. Therefore, I am selecting the mask and just use something like 20 pixels for the mask feather. And next, I have to rearrange my background layer to get rid of that duplicating effect here. Now I just need to move my background layer further down. And to not get a blank space, like you can see at the top of my composition, I also need to animate the position of my background layer. So at the end of my composition, I'm moving my background footage up again. And this was it. Now you have a nice, good-looking vertical zoom effect.